Welcome to the session of OET Reading Part A. I'm Tina Sebastian, one of the OET students of MAD OET, with the great support of Father Saline Joseph, our great mentor. So today I'm going to deal with Reading Part A. Our OET reading consists of three parts, A, B, and C. And today we will be discussing about Reading Part A. And most of you know what is Reading Part A. It consists of 20 questions. And we will have to finish it within 15 minutes. And before giving any tips or tricks, I would like to give you all a humble suggestion that we must be patient enough and we must have persistent practice. And this patience and persistent practice will give us all the success, and we will be able to complete the reading task in time. And this OET reading is not going to assess your medical knowledge, only your competency in English. Today, I would like to give you some tips and tricks which Father has taught us, and I would like to explain it in my own way. First of all, skimming and scanning. Skimming and scanning is nothing but we have to search for some headings, subheadings, numbers, names, chronological order, narrations, any scales, modal verbs, all those things. We must be well aware of all this. And when we do skimming, search for all these things. Reading Part A, we have mainly four paragraphs. It is Test A, Test B, Test C, and Test D. Mostly, the OET Reading Part A comes with definition, clinical assessment, investigation, medical management, surgical management, and sometimes it is prevention. So how are we going to tackle? So when we start reading Part A, we must focus or we must sequence it. So in Part A, 90% it will be definition, and the second will be clinical assessment or diagnostic or investigations. And Test C will be management. It will be either medical or surgical. And D will be monitoring and prevention. And in reading part, if you don't have a heading or subheading, please read the introduction line of each paragraph. And for each paragraph, you have to only spend 15 seconds to answer the question. So from 1 to 7, you can do it within 1 to 2 minutes. We can I'm damn sure that we can finish it off within 2 minutes if you follow the strategies well. In definition, if you don't have heading and if you have 2-3 paragraphs, just go and read the first line of each paragraph. That will give you a clear idea of what is the entire paragraph is. And even in the second text B, it might be given clinical assessment. And if you have seen clinical assessment in the introduction para of the Test B, don't go to read Test C. Go just skim down below. Sometimes along with clinical assessment, they will be given diagnostic measures as well. So just skim it and go to Test C. Test C will be management. Either it will be medical management or surgical management. Just have a glance over it. And then the fourth paragraph is prevention, or it will be monitoring. Next, we can do it in an easy way. If we really understand what is definition, what is clinical assessment, what is medication or management, or what is prevention, we will be able to understand where our question is and which paragraph it belongs to. So for example, if we take headache, it can be, can anyone say headache belongs to which one? Is it symptom, definition?
Symptom.
Yes. Gallstones.
Definition.
And vomiting will be?
Symptoms.
Yes. Painkillers.
Management.
Yes. Fever.
Symptoms.
Yes. And CT.
Diagnostic procedure.
Plenty of fluid.
Management.
Yes. Hand hygiene.
Prevention and management.
Prevention.
Yes. Polylithiasis.
Diagnostic procedure.
Yes. Cholangitis.
Infection.
Definition.
Definition.
Family history.
clinical
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 assessment.
Yes. Ultrasound.
Diagnostic.
Yeah. Angiography.
Diagnostic.
Diagnostic measures, right? Polycystitis.
Definition.
LFT.
Investigation.
Right. Investigation. Polycystectomy.
Management.
And balanced diet is
management.
Avoid butter.
Prevention.
Murphy's test.
Diagnostic. Clinical assessment.
Okay. Jaundice.
Signs and symptoms.
Weight loss. Weight loss.
Clinical assessment.
Simple analgesia.
Management.
Management.
And lifestyle activities.
Management.
So if we are very sure of this, then why we are worried about tackling reading part A? Okay. Here I would like to also give you some more tips. If we are checking for a number, just go and skim for a number only. But be sure that from 1st to 9th, it will be written in letter. It will not be shown as number. So we must be very careful with. Okay. So we will have to, if it is a number, just go and scan only numbers. But be sure that from 1st to 9th, it will be written in letters. So it will be confusing. So just be mindful of that as well. And if it is in chronological order, like before, after, another, next, all those things we must be looking for. And if we come across all this type of words, the answers will be mostly near to it. And do not ever try to change the answers. What is exactly in the reading paragraph, you just cut and paste it. Should not try to make your own mistakes that will lead to incorrect answer. And other 7 golden principles that our father taught us, we must have the capacity to understand the synonyms. So the synonyms has got a major play in reading part A as well as in all the other modules. And the second one, you must understand the scales. I hope all of you know what is scales. For the newcomers, we have already shared the PPT in Telegram. Please go through it if you haven't understood. And the narrations and the indirect speech and direct speech, report speech, all this we must be well versed in. Otherwise, we won't be able to get a good score or get the correct answer from it. And the adjectives as well. Adjectives in the sense, high temperature. If it is mentioned high temperature, we must write high temperature. If not, our answer will be wrong. If you write only temperature, your answer is going to be wrong. So we must be very careful with the adjectives as well. And the other tip is, let your previous reading help you to move forward. If you have achieved 20 out of 20 today, tomorrow also you must have that score, same score. You should not, the score should not go down. And you, as I said earlier, you have to write as exactly as from the test. And the other thing, if you haven't found the answer, please don't be panic. Just go forward. Keep aside the question which we did not get. Go forward with the next question. Then you can come back later to complete the answer. And if you practice it in to do the entire task in 9 minutes, you will be able to get good score, 20 out of 20, because you will have plenty of time for proofreading. You can cross check, you can make sure all the answers are correct or not. You should have love and practice it with love. Majority of the candidates mostly say that they are fed up with reading, and reading is really tough. Don't think that way. Fall in love with OET reading, and you can easily crack all the questions in Part A. So today I have a topic with you all. So let us do it together. Let us understand how we can find out the answer. Okay, the passages is about the gallstones. So the first question is, let us go to have a glimpse of the paragraph first. See, in text one, we don't have a major headings here. Neither we have a headings, but everywhere in the introduction line itself, it is written as gallstone. And we have 2-3 paragraph here. So if you come down, there is cholangitis, cholecystitis. So we can be sure biliary colic, all those things are there. So it is definitely belongs to definitions, because only we need to look gallstones, biliary colic, cholangitis, cholecystitis. With this, we can understand that this passage belongs to definition only. Let us move to the second test. It's clinical assessment. Presence of fever, perform abdominal examination including Murphy test, diagnostic test include. See, this much only we need to look for the paragraph. Don't ever try to read the paragraph, because you will waste the time. When you do from 8 to 20, you will have plenty of time to read. So just go skim and scan. Now we can move to text 3. It is treatment of gallstone. So when we see treatment of gallstone, if you don't go down to read or skim, sometimes we may misunderstand that it is only talking about medical management. So in this paragraph, we have some medical management as well as some surgical options are there. So we must be mindful of that. Let us move to text 4. It is ways to prevent gallstone. It's talking about prevention. There is no 2-3 paragraph, so only we need to check for prevention. Now let us look the questions from 1 to 7. How gallstones are confirmed? From here itself, we have to understand we have to find out what is the keyword here, and this paragraph belongs to. This question belongs to which paragraph? We must make sure from the question itself. So confirmation is nothing but it's a type of test. So you need not go to Part A, C, D. Only you can focus on B. Right. We have seen clinical assessment along with diagnostic investigation. Right?
Yes, yes.
So our answer is D. The second one is signs a person has jaundice.
B.
Signs a person has jaundice.
B.
We must be very careful with it. So you are telling that it is B. Sometimes in the definition itself, they might tell some yellowish discoloration in the first paragraph. Sometimes paragraph, jaundice developed towards end, it can cause persistent pain, fever, nausea, pain, vomiting.
Is there. Yes.
Have you all seen?
Yes.
Yes. Must be very cautious when you give answer. And when we go to read clinical assessment or signs and symptoms in the next second paragraph, if you don't find it, just go for definition, because the signs will be mentioned in definition only. It will not come in management or prevention. And third one, what type of food to avoid to prevent gallstone? This is the question is directly. Which one? D. right?
B.
So the next question, fourth one, surgical options available for ladies with gallstone in the third trimester.
Management.
And the fifth one, biliary colic. Obviously it is A. And the sixth one is pharmaceutical option for managing gallstone. And the seventh one is the key evidence that suggests gallstones captured when taking the patient's history. Key evidence that suggests gallstone captured when taking the patient's history.
B.
So have you all understood how we can conclude and get the answers within a fraction of seconds?
Yes, Tina.
Yes, clear.
So we must be very, when you read the question itself, you must try to understand this question belongs to which paragraph. So you can avoid reading all the entire passages from top to bottom. Just focus on it and we will have more time. So let us move, shall we move to eighth question?
Yes.
What type of cheese should be avoided to reduce the risk of developing gallstone? So what do you think? Which passage is it will be? What type of question is this?
B. In D.
In D, right? Prevention. B. Now, what type of cheese should be avoided? So it is in D. So definitely we will go for
D. Prevention.
Text D, yeah, right. So shall we move to text D?
Yes.
Text 4, please.
D.
Yes. See, here it is, hard cheese. Avoid eating too many foods. Hard cheese in the middle portion.
Yes, hard cheese. Hard.
So hard only cheese. We need to write hard,
hard
because cheese is already written in the
question.
Eighth one. And ninth one, what test is usually carried out to check for gallstones? What test? It is an investigation, right?
Investigation.
So where it will be? In part B, right?
Text B.
Yeah. So shall we look into text B? Ultrasound, the most common diagnostic test for gallstones. Got it?
Yes.
Shall we move to 10? Okay. 10th question.
Yes.
If a person has cholecystitis, what part of their body is affected? If a person has cholecystitis, what part of their body is affected?
Gallbladder.
Yeah, it will be definition part, right? Because they are talking about cholecystitis.
Yes.
Okay.
So in text one, there is cholecystitis, inflammation of the gallbladder.
Yes.
So the gallbladder is affected with the cholecystitis.
Right.
The 11th question, the gallbladder and what else might be removed during laparoscopic cholecystectomy? Simply, we can understand that the question belongs to paragraph C.
Management.
So, in text 3, there will be answer. No need to go here and there. Focus on text 3. Remove the gallbladder and any stones in the cystic duct. You should mention stones. Don't write stone alone. Must write stones. So we'll move to 12th question. Diets that are low calorie leading to what should be avoided?
Prevention.
So the answer is in D. It's in prevention part. Yeah.
D.
Text 4. 13th question. A blood test may be taken from a person suspected of having gallstones to check the functioning of which organ? So it is a diagnostic investigation.
Liver.
Yeah, and this is
liver.
We need not even read the text. We all know that when there is gallstones or cholecystitis, the liver function is deranged. So in shall we move to 14?
Yes.
Which non-surgical treatment is now mostly used to treat kidney stones? It's non-surgical treatment. So yes. It's then test
C.
C. Do you all want to go to the passage to read it?
Yeah.
Non-surgical treatment options. Next slide. Next slide talks about lithotripsy. 15th question. In approximately of dash case of cases, people with gallstones are asymptomatic. So here, approximately, what will be the answer? Is it a number or something of that sort, right?
Number.
Yeah, only we need to look for numbers. And guess where, which paragraph it, this question belongs to? Low intake, 16, low intake of cash can keep the risk of developing gallstones low. Low intake of DASH can keep the risk of developing gallstones low. Prevention part, right?
Prevention.
Yes. Prevention. Shall we move to text 4?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Low calorie.
No, drinking small amount of alcohol may also help reduce risk of gallstones. Okay, 17th one. During surgery, if gallstones are found, the bile duct is expanded with a minor cut or and dash.
60.
Management.
Yes.
So, what is the answer? It can test C.
Test duct.
An electrically heated wire. With a small incision, the synonymous is given here, cut, or an article is also mentioned, electrically heated wire. Okay, 18th one. A person may appear yellow if a gallstone occludes a dash connecting to the bowel. Occurs when a bile duct becomes blocked. It is in?
Yes.
Our answer is bile duct.
Yeah.
So the 19th one, during the clinical assessment of a patient presenting with a possible gallstone, an abdominal examination carried out including dash.
B.
So definitely the answer will be
B.
So perform abdominal examination including
Murphy's test.
Yes. And the 20th question, last but not the least. Cholelithiasis are solid lumps of dash
that
can grow in the gallbladder.
Definition.
Definition.
So the first line itself gives us the answer. Gallstones, cholelithiasis, are hardened deposit of digestive fluid that can form in the gallbladder. So that is the reading style and how we have to crack it. Hope all of you have understood. So this is how we do reading part A. Hope all of you have understood. Do you have any more clarifications? So in reading part A, if anyone is newcomers, my suggestion is not to read the entire part in the beginning. And many trainers and OET trainers have commented that we must start the answer from 8 to 20. But it is not the case. From 1 to 7, we can easily crack all the question answers from 1 to 7 easily. So don't ever try to skip it. From the beginning itself, you can do it from 1 to 7 and it will give you a more idea about what the passages are. And as I said in the beginning, please follow all the strategies. And if you don't know even a single one, please make sure to thorough it. Like scales, adjectives, direct speech and indirect speech or reported speech. All this, we must be well-versed. Otherwise, it is very difficult to understand. As reading, they are assessing our competency in English. We must be well-versed in grammar part as well. So thank you all for your active participation.
Good evening all. Tina, you have done a wonderful job. You have taken an initiative to guide us in a proper way with the examples of the questions with the answers. It is not an easy task to take an effort and do it, but you have done for the well-being of us. We are very grateful to you, and definitely the strategies which have been given by Father Salim and which you have highlighted, we are going to imbibe in our practice. Keep going, keep rocking. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you, Shalini.
And, yeah,
bye. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Just I want to thank you today, especially Tina. It was a nice session. And I feel a little more, I think it will become more easier now. Yeah, how we can find the answer. And you nicely explained. And then future, we are also planning to say all the best. And keep rocking. And yeah. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Tina. It was a wonderful presentation. God bless you. And you have explained everything nicely. It was like a revision kind of thing for us. So, thank you. Thank you, Father, for giving all of us this opportunity. Because this video challenge really helps us.
Yes.
Thank you.
Good evening, one and all. First of all, I want to say thanks for Tina. Thank you, Tina. You have done a wonderful job. Nothing more to say. Speechless. You did a great job and you are encouraging the newcomers. Then one word for the newcomers. Follow our mentor, Father Salim's strategies. And these strategies are available exclusively only in our family, not in any other platform. So please watch his videos and you can gain confidence in doing part A. Most of the institutions are asking you to practice from question number 8. As Tina mentioned, only in our platform, only in our family, I want to say family, only in our family, Father is teaching us to start from the right beginning. So you can finish question number 1 to 7 in less than 2 minutes. So follow Father's strategy, please. And thank you all.
I want to tell congratulations to Tina. So you are taking wonderful initiation. And this is more encouraging to us. I too feel jealousy over her because I want to do same. And yes, it is wonderful. I have no words. Yeah, keep going, dear. Okay, that's all.
Good evening, Tina. You did it very well, and you explained in a simple way. So it is very easy to understand all. And thank you, Tina. Really, I'm appreciating you. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, Tina, you done a wonderful job. And everyone knows it is not easy work. You did a great job.
Thank you.
And Tina, it's really beautiful. I don't want to say much words because everyone knows that there is no more to add. It's really beautiful. And for me, I really like your class. It was like a chocolate because I just understand whatever you mean in every sense. So I'm so thankful to you, Tina.
Thank you,
Andy. And
good evening, all. I'm a beginner to OET, and this is my first class. I'm really interested, and I don't know how to. Even though I attended one course of class, and this is really a new approach for me. I didn't study there in all this, way how to crack the A parts, and it is really interesting and it's very informative. Thank you, Tina. Your classes, and even I watched the father class, and it was very informative. And even with today's class, I got more information, and I will be following regularly your classes.